This is Angellic Voice, ASMR, and I'm here with a book tag challenge. The book tag challenge, which I will be participating in, is going to be the Do I Have That Book Challenge. So it is a timed challenge. So I've got my stopwatch here. And it's going to be going as I try to find the book on my shelves. So, this challenge has 20 questions. And so, without further ado, let's hit start and get going with the first question, which is, do you have a book with deckled edges? That one's easy. That is going to be The Light Between Worlds by Laura E. Weymouth. Or Weymouth? I don't know how to pronounce your name, Laura. I am so sorry. So, Light Between Worlds by Laura Weymouth. So, that leads us to question number two. Do you have a book with three or more people on the cover? I don't know if this counts. Well, I don't know if this counts, but I'm gonna count it. I'm gonna say that complete Alice in Wonderland by Lewis Carroll, because we've got Alice, the March Hare, and the Mad Hatter. I'm going to count the hare as a person. I don't know if that's technically allowed, but I'm counting it. So, next, do you have a book based on another fictional story? Yes, I do. Based on another fictional story. Let's see. We have got... Oh, give me just a second. It's not on my shelf right now, but I am currently reading Second Star by J.M. Sullivan. It is based on Peter Pan. And next question, number four, is do you have a book with a title that is 10 letters long? Second Star would have worked for that. This is hard. Four, eight, nope. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, nope. is Still Alice by Lisa Genova. It is 10 letters long. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 letters long. Okay. Oh, geez, I'm only on question 4. Question 5. Do you have a letter? Do you have a book that with a title that starts and ends with the same letter? Gonna cheat here and use The Hobbit. The end of Hobbit. Okay, so, do you have a mass market paperback book? Probably. Does it say anywhere where a mass market, if it's a mass market paperback? If not, I'm probably gonna go with Echoes of an Angel by Aquanetta Gordon, I think. Correct me if I'm wrong, guys, but I'm gonna use that as my mass market and hope it's right, because I don't pay attention to are mass market or not. Do you have a book written by an author using a pen name? Oh, I'm sure I do. I'm sure I do. Well, you know what? I think was H.G. Wells' pen name? I don't know. Things are falling over. No, nothing is a pen name. Nothing really about Nemo. Oh, jeez. Can I really not find anything by anybody in a pen name with a pen name? Really? Okay, well, I don't think I have anything with a pen name, you guys, so if there's anything that you guys can see or think of that I might have that as an author using a pen name, let me know. Okay, so next question is, do you have a book with a character's name in the title? So let's not go for the obvious. Let's go for the slightly less obvious. Let's go for Anne of Green Gables. So Anne, of course. And next question is, do you have a book with two maps in it? Oh shoot, and of course I used The Hobbit. Let's see, what else would have maps in it? Does it turn all the way down on the map? I think it does. Everything is falling off my bookcase, guys. Oh my gosh. Turn all the way down, that's a map, doesn't it? No? No? It doesn't have a... Oh, John, why are you doing this to me? You don't have a map. I'm disappointed in you, John. But I betcha Elyon has one map, and... Can't I just have a map book, guys? Like, one hand. Oh, no. Cheat here, and I'm gonna use the Bible because I know this has maps in it. Somewhere. Maybe in the back. So you've got the Exodus, and you've got the world of the patriarchs. You've got Empire of David and Solomon, Palestine and Jesus' time, Paul's missionary journeys, and travel of the apostles. So you've got many, many maps in the Bible. So, the Bible. Do you have a book that was turned into a TV show?
Yes, I do. I do. Neil Gaiman. Because I have.
Someone who is originally famous for someone for something else.
Originally famous for something else. Originally famous for something else. Yes, I do.
Neil Patrick Harris. His autobiography. So obviously famous. I still have to read, I guess. I still need to, because I think that's such a cool idea. Do you have a book with a clock on the cover?
Yeah, I should. I believe.
That was what I was banking on.
Okay. Oh, the clock on the cover with a clock on the cover.
this after I won the Pulitzer. Oh my gosh. Because I bought it super late. Do I have a book written by an author with the same initials as me? genuinely curious.
Okay, so I don't